Hello and welcome back to a classic circuit, familiar to fans the world over. This is Monza. You can hear the cars ready to go. Certainly the fans are ready for some action. We're all set. So let's get this Formula 2 race underway. Monza is situated 12 miles northeast of Milan. It's 3.6 miles long and offers 11 corners. Seven of those are chicanes, putting a premium on good braking stability and traction. With a good slipstream plus the other two DRS zones available, there should be a good number of passing opportunities on offer. Let's take a look at the grid positions for today's race. Old Timer lines up on pole position, with Richard Vachon alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Tictum, Lawson, Guan Yu Zhou, and Aitken. Sato, Deruvola, Lundgaard, Marcus Armstrong, Fittipaldi, Drugovic, Teo Pourchaire, and Beckman. Vips, Schwartzman, Piastri, and Larim Zendeli. Nissani, Samaya, Boschong, and Alessio Deledda rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Turn one at Monza is famous, or should I say infamous, for serious contact and incidents, especially on the opening lap. What are your thoughts on that, Davide?
Yes, this chicane is a tricky one. A lot of time you see the more experienced drivers hold back from full throttle to keep themselves safe as everyone tries to squeeze into the racing line after the opening straight.
This is the team's home race. We're all relying on you to impress today. Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap, please. We're learning the gears, so let's go through them all if you can. Okay, not the best placement there, mate. Let's try and get a good launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. behind is 7.7 seconds. They're on old mediums. They're going to have 4 laps on their tyres, and the time last lap was at 1:33.5. Absolutely fantastic. That is a brilliant, brilliant result. Well done.
A great win then for the Trident team today. And Davide Valsecchi, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
It was down to one thing: consistent pace over everyone else out there on the track. We could spend a great deal of time talking about race and tire strategy, what has occurred on the track, but at the end of the day, the difference here was down to simply being faster on track than everyone else. Amazing skill on show.
It's the part we've all been waiting for, the podium finish, and it's probably one of the more unexpected finishes in a while. Trident take the victory, and Trident have made huge strides within F2 recently, and today proves that they're not only still in the race, but they're in it to win. Congratulations to everyone on the team. After this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Oldtimer takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. And so, driver of the day then, Davide Valsecchi, who do you think you'd go for?
I'll probably go for Enzo Fittipaldi. The team did a good job with the strategy to put him in the pack, and he was good enough to take the opportunities.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Teams' Championship. Trident move further ahead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, Carlin move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.